Well, it seems like the reporters aren't here, but we'll just go ahead anyway, right?
Parece que los reporteros, las cámaras no han llegado, pero vamos a comenzar, ¿está bien?
I want to try something, Mom. So make some noise if you love your immigrant mom.
¡Hagan ruido!
I try to call my mom, make her breakfast in bed, write her a card, spend some time with her because she raised me. You know, she was a young mom, an immigrant in a new country, but she was the backbone of my family.
Y cada día, de vez en cuando le echo una llamada a mi madre. Él está muy agradecido, es la persona que lo crió a él. Y vino a este país como madre inmigrante. Se sacrificó también por él.
I mean, immigrant moms are the backbone of all our communities. Immigrant moms raise us. They work hard to feed us. They take care of our home. They take care of our families. And not only that, they're leading the movement for immigrant rights and immigration reform.
Las madres inmigrantes nos han criado, se han sacrificado, han hecho lo que han hecho por nosotros. Y ellas son las que han creado este movimiento.
So we're here today to not only celebrate Mother's Day, get ready to celebrate, but to say thank you to all the moms in our community, and we're here for two reasons.
So estamos aquí no nada más para celebrar Día de las Madres, y con ese me fue lo otro. We're here to celebrate Mother's Day for two reasons. Se me fue el avión, perdónenme.
So reason number one, we want to show the community, we want to show Congressman Ed Royce. We're not going away, we're not tired, we're still fighting for immigration reform, right?
So reason number one is porque queremos enseñarle, demostrarle a la comunidad que estamos acá, no nos vamos a ningún lado, pero también al congresista que vamos a seguir luchando y vamos a seguir de pie. Eso es lo de pie yo lo agregué.
And reason number two, we're here to hear the stories of powerful, inspirational, loving immigrant moms in our community and show the power of love in leading us forward in the fight for immigration reform.
Y razón número dos, estamos aquí también para escuchar las historias bien poderosas de algunas de las madres que van a compartir con nosotros al ratito.
And so the first person speaking to us, and we hope this message, you know, gets transmitted to the Congressman's office, is a local community member, a leader with OFO, and someone who I have so much admiration and respect for. Please welcome Ms. Analeti Hernandez.
So Analeti is the
somewhere that
value person.
Tenemos la confianza de que él va a apoyar esta reforma porque ya es justo y necesario. Muchos niños están sin sus madres, están faltando a las escuelas, muchas personas se han estado suicidando porque están pasando muy triste esta situación de no tener su familia unida. Yo les pido a todas las madres que sigamos orando para que esto se solucione pronto.
Adelante esas madres que vinieron. Adelante esas madres que vinieron a triunfar. No dejemos que nos quiten a nuestros hijos. Venimos a luchar en este país y tenemos que salir adelante, echarle ganas. Lo más importante es tener una actividad. Ayudemos en las escuelas a ir, a veces no podemos ir por lo mismo, que son racistas, tenemos que salir adelante, echarle ganas. Y les deseo de todo corazón que Dios le va a tocar el corazón para que den esa firma.
It's hard for them to go to the children's schools without being looked down upon because of where they come. And she hopes that will open up and
start. Yo como madre, como abuela y actualmente como bisabuela, yo veo en el futuro a mis nietos y a mis bisnietos en este país creciendo como debe de ser, que no haya esa injusticia como lo han estado haciendo con todos nosotros.
Their great-grandchildren growing up, and they see that they're making a better living for the community, and they don't want them to be treated like they were treated.
Y yo sé que tarde o temprano el señor Ed Royce va a estar aquí con nosotros, porque él es una persona de comunidad, está apoyando otras comunidades y debe de estar también apoyándonos a nosotros que somos de su distrito.
Helps all the people in different communities, and hopefully he'll come and help because they're part of his district and he should be able to help.
Estamos aquí, estoy yo aquí junto con mi compañera para si su staff nos está escuchando, para que le haga saber que no vamos nosotros a dejar de estar persistiendo en querer verlo. Queremos ver y queremos oír de su boca lo que él quiere decirnos a nosotros.
Para que toda la gente también de los restaurantes puedan escuchar.
They're here so he could come out and help them and let them know that he will help. They want to hear it from his mouth.
Next, I want to introduce my colleague, a mother of five, friend. Her name is Jongnam Kim, and she's from the Korean Resource Center.
Hello, my name is Jongnam. Legal name is Elizabeth Jongnam Kim. I'm working on the Korean Resource Center. Luckily, me and my five children have legal status. But every day I thank God how much blessing I have. But my friend, she's mother of two children. Her children and my children, they are friends. And me and she's friends. They go to same school, eat lunch together, go to theater together. I'm smiling to see them, but she cries to see them because they are undocumented. Why mothers crying in a happy Mother's Day? We need to pass the bill right now. Thank you.
Hagan ruido si ustedes quieren a las madres inmigrantes. Okay, next, let's introduce Katie Brazer. She's a lead community member and a leader with OCO, Orange County Congregation Community Organization.
I'm so happy to be here today with all of you. It's been so many times we've been here, right? Over the last year and a half, countless amount of times. But I'm so happy that, you know, we're still keeping this up here in Orange County and that our voices are strong. Something I realized here in Orange County is that this fight is so beautiful. You know, the struggles that everyone is facing, all of our families, all of the mothers that, you know, possibly won't be able to celebrate this Sunday. The suffering is so real, but there's something so beautiful that Ed Royce, his staff, no one, you know, can fully understand. And we can see that because of their lack of action. So that experience that most of us here have shared, whether it's because of our neighbors who are suffering or our own families, you know, that's keeping us going. And we really need immigration reform here in Orange County. Hopefully Ed Royce will finally hear our voices. But even if not, you know, we're going to keep doing this. We have so many families here who are counting on this, but I hope that this, you know, for me, seeing families here supporting each other is something so special. But, you know, with documents, people like Ed Royce will never have that value in their life. So I just wanted to say that I really appreciate being part of this movement, and that I'm here with you until we win. And hopefully, you know, Orange County, we can lead the way. Our representatives hopefully will have a change of heart. Maybe as they share Mother's Day with their families, they'll be thinking about us. So thank you. Para compartir este movimiento con todos de ustedes. Yo sé que la gente en este movimiento tiene más importancia que la gente que no tiene esta situación y más valor de sus vidas. Es algo muy, muy bonito. Pero sí, ojalá que los congresistas puedan oír nosotros. Y yo estoy con ustedes. Por toda esta lucha, antes de nos ganen una reforma migratoria. Gracias.
Thank you, Katie. You know, I think your words were so beautiful. It reminded me of a chant. You guys all know it, right? The people united will never be divided. 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 El pueblo unido jamás será vencido. El pueblo unido jamás será vencido. El pueblo unido jamás será vencido. Alright, next up, I want to welcome a member of SEIU USWW United Service Workers West, Alicia Diaz.
Bravo, Alicia.
Buenos días, yo soy Alicia Diaz y soy una madre inmigrante.
Hello, my name is Alicia Diaz and I am an immigrant mother.
Yo vine a este país hace 25 años.
I came to this country 25 years ago.
Y vine a luchar porque me traje a mis hijos.
I came to move forward with my family. She came with myself and my other two siblings.
Y pues no me gustaría, ¿verdad?, que a mí me deportaran, porque pues aquí tengo a mi familia, a mis hijos, a mis nietos y a mis bisnietos.
She wouldn't want to get deported because she has her kids, her grandkids and grandkids.
Y pues yo le pido al congresista que pues que nos apoye y que no está muerto la lo de invitación.
And she hopes that he will support the movement and help out.
Eso es todo. Okay.
se puede.
Next we got, I'd be happy to introduce Debbie Langenbacher. I hope that pronounced that someone right. She's from the Unitarian Universalist Church, and she's standing on the side of love with immigrant families.
As mothers, grandmothers, and women of faith are called upon to take higher moral ground to support the disenfranchised, the bound bodies, and those who are suffering. As Unitarian Universalists, we are especially driven to uphold our principle of the inherent worth and dignity of all people. One of the campaigns of the Unitarian Universal Congregation has been immigration as a moral issue, as well as standing on the side of love with immigrant families. We are called upon to stand with the vulnerable and the oppressed, to treat our neighbors as we would like to be treated, and this principle is found in all religions. Our current immigration system disproportionately affects women and children, burdening our foster care system when parents are deported, and threatening the promising futures of students who come to the United States as children and consider this country their home. In the Unitarian Universalist campaign for immigration as a moral issue, we say that a system that breaks apart families is itself broken. Our immigration system was last overhauled in 1986. Under the administration of Republican President Ronald Reagan. The slogans of the time and of his campaign were the moral majority and family values. Where is the morality in our current immigration system? How are we valuing families, especially once the parents of some of our youngest citizens are being deported? I wonder what these citizens will think of their country and of the immigration system when they are deported. Call upon Mr. Royce to use his influence in the House of Representatives for passage of compassionate immigration reform that values the human rights of immigrants, especially that families not be torn apart, giving dreamers the chance to pursue their ambitions, higher education and careers, and to offer a humane pathway to citizenship. Our country was founded on welcoming immigrants and providing opportunity for those leaving adverse situations. This is a tradition that should be honored. As people of faith, we are morally obligated to welcome the stranger. We encourage Mr. Royce to think beyond a narrow focus on immigration and building a fence or harsh penalties. And we want him to consider immigration as a moral issue. This is a moral issue that especially affects women and their children. Thank you.
Thank you, Debbie, for that beautiful speech. I think, you know, we're all a little bit disappointed that we don't have more members of the media to record this event, but it's okay because we know that we were here, and we know that the Congressman's office knows that we were here. We're sustaining this movement. We're not giving up. We're just getting stronger every day. I think one thing that drives our conviction in this movement is love, and another one is faith and community. So in that spirit, I want to thank and invite Father Ricardo Aguilar to lead us in a closing prayer.
Quiero decirles a ustedes que le pedimos a Elroy que respete las garantías de los niños ciudadanos americanos, de que crezcan junto a su mamá. No podemos llamar Mother's Day, Día de la Madre, si no se pueden respetar esos derechos en ser deportados. El Señor esté con vosotros. Señor, te damos gracias por este día. Te pedimos de manera especial, bendigas a todas las mamás inmigrantes que luchan y se esfuerzan por el trabajo diario para mantener a su familia y que a diario te piden, Señor, que cuides de ellas y de sus hijos para que no sean deportadas. En este día especial te pedimos que derrames tu Espíritu Santo en cada una de ellas y les fortalezcas grandemente, como también a nosotros que luchamos y apoyamos esta reforma migratoria. En el nombre de Jesús te lo pedimos. Amén.
Amén.